I feel like it might start in the weight room, you know, doing a little stuff in the weight room. And just pretty much just focusing in on stopping your man, stopping the person in front of you. It's not too many tricks you can really learn to play defense. It's really just all about you guarding your man, manning up to your responsibilities.
So it's like a mindset, just saying, I'm going to do it, I'm
going to
do it.
Yeah.
Kenny, you guys as players got a lot of things on your mind, just you know, playing, improving your opponent, scattering reports and all that. Does the fans enter into it at all? Like, you know, you want the Tennessee fans to support you, and you know that, you know, losing a game to Austin Peay hurts. Does that fit in at all into all the things you guys have to think about?
Nah, I mean, we're not focused on fans or anything. Our biggest focus is us as a team, you know. But we appreciate the fans who are there, the loyal fans, you know, who stay around and who cheer for us, whatever. But, you know, they're not in our locker room. They're not on the court. They're not at our practices. So, you know, our biggest thing is us. We're concerned with us first before anything else.
Coach, how much Mark, different is it for you being in those kind of smaller gyms, like, you know, the one maybe Oakland had and the one that y'all played in Maui and the one that you're going to on Wednesday, as opposed to those kind of big arenas y'all are used to in this league?
I mean, you know, we've all played in smaller gyms. I mean, it's just a basketball court, whether you're playing in TBA or you're playing, you know, on a blacktop somewhere. It's a basketball court, you know. We're expected to go out there and play basketball. So the size of the gym or the arena, it doesn't really bother us. I mean, we're all from high school, so we all played in small gyms before, so that's not really a factor, not to me at least.
I know some guards have said before that maybe it affects their perimeter shot more than anything. For a post guy, it's probably just not that much of a deal. I mean, you're usually shooting fairly close to the bucket anyway,
yeah. Yeah, I mean, as far as that, I can't really cope with them on that.
I know you guys say you put same area emphasis on all the games, but how big is this next game? When you guys went to Oakland, it was right after Hawaii, and nobody used the jet lag as an excuse, but it was what it was. This College of Charleston game on the road, I mean, is there a lot being put into this game after this last setback?
Yeah, it's most definitely a must win. I mean, losing three straight, two at home, it's important for us to go on the road and get this victory. We do remember them coming in last year and just dominating us, so that's another, you know, another push for us as a team to go to their home and beat them.
You guys are rather blue last conference too, right? I mean, you've thought about that guy that dominated.
Yeah, we are glad that he's gone, but I mean, we still got to go out there and execute. They still have a pretty good team without him.
Coach talked a lot about the defense breaking down. When you're in the middle of a game, why is it that you can't change that mindset of fixing things on defense and not focusing on offense?
Can you repeat that, please?
When you're in the middle of the game and you notice that your defense is breaking down, why isn't that something that's fixable mid-game?
You know, really it's all about, you know, we just need, you know, the proper leadership. I mean, I think we all do a pretty good job of speaking up at times, but, you know, the leadership has to be consistent, and, you know, we all have to buy in and trust each other. I think sometimes at times we might not trust one another and all that tie in together. So we just have to do a better job of just trusting one another.
Is that a role that you're willing to take?
Yeah, if I have to, whatever to help my team.
Is that a role that's easier to take now, Ken? You're really in the year when you were kind of finding your way in the paint, you had some struggles, it was clear you were frustrated that things weren't going down. You look like you kind of hit your groove. Does that make it a little easier now for you to be vocal and maybe kind of pay attention to what some other people are doing as far as their responsibilities?
Most definitely. That is a part that I have to, you know, do a better job in, stepping up and being more vocal on the court. And, you know, it's not always the easiest thing to do, you know, coming at certain players certain ways, because you also have to look at yourself in the mirror and first, you know, be real with yourself and correct what you're doing wrong. And it starts off by leading by example. So I think before you could really check somebody else, you got to make sure you got your own stuff straight. But at the same time, you got to be willing to let them know where they're failing at, you know, what mistakes they're making at this, you know.
Coach, Coach Martin said even when you were having your struggles earlier, you were still coming in the gym early, you were still working on your days off. What pushed you into that? Because on the court, the success wasn't there, and yet you were still doing the extra things.
I wanted to be good. I mean, if, you know, y'all seen the games, the shots I was missing, I wanted to improve that. I don't like going out there missing shots. To me, that's, you know, for a big man, that's not a good look. You know, especially on a team where a post presence is needed. And, you know, for me not being that presence, you know, that's not a good feeling. So it's just my own drive. I want to get better and help my team out.
Obviously, the team is much different. The lineup and the guys who are on the team are much different this year than from last year's team. So, how much are y'all still finding your way as a team, especially on the court?
We're still trying to find our way. You know, it's pretty much basically a new team. You know, everybody, all the starters are new. You know, bench players except for Cam. And, you know, it's a whole new team, so we're just all learning how to play together and, you know, at the same time, deal with the experience that's been out there on the court.
Are you starting to feel that change at all, where you're getting more comfortable with one another?
Yeah, you know, as time goes along, you know, and the more we practice, you start to get your teammates' niche, you know, kind of what they like to do in situations, you know. Like me and Trey, we got this thing like, eye contact thing. I said, before you do anything, make sure we have eye contact and to know we're on the same page. So, you know, it's just little stuff like that.
Coach Martin said that you have to believe before you can go full throttle. Mm-hmm. Do you feel like you're going full throttle right now?
Most definitely. We got to just continue to keep on going. You know, we got to put those losses behind us. Not forgetting the losses and just, you know, learning from our mistakes and keep it pushing. There's still a long season ahead of us.
Can you talk about DMU and learning, you know, learning guys, learning the roles and everything? Did you feel that in late the second half on Saturday when maybe somebody was, you know, not quite anxious to step up and take that big shot where last year, you know, Scotty or Tobias probably took that role?
See, last year it was more of a, like, we knew exactly, you know, who was expected to get the last shot. We know who the play was being drawn up for. This year, I think we're all trying to be that one guy or waiting for Coach to, you know, like, let us know who's that go-to guy. And really, in my opinion, I think it's whoever has the hot hand, you know, that game. Because every game we had, it's always been one person to just have a good game and be hot on offense. So I think as far as right now, it's just whoever has the hot hand, that's who we're going with.
Is it difficult for you to demand the ball sometimes? You know, Conzo was talking about that a second ago, how you and Jerron are not really selfish guys by nature, but you got to demand the ball from time to time.
Yeah, it's not difficult. It's just a matter of me speaking up more. Once again, part of me being more vocal, that's one of the things that I would like to stress. And that's something me and Jerron both definitely need to do, just speak up more.
Were you aware that you and Jerron had such a high percentage during that game? I mean, I'm sure you realized you were taking and making the shots, but did you know that y'all were like a combined 15 for 17 or 13 for 15 or whatever it was?
No, I didn't know the numbers or whatever, but I do know we was having a pretty good game as far as shooting or scoring.
Okay.